If ever you wondered how yoga, meditation, and Indian wisdom first entered the popular American conversation, then you will need to travel back in time to the turn of the 20th century. In 1893, America celebrated its golden age. The World's Columbian Exposition of Chicago was designed to demonstrate America's growing global power and was also host to the world's first Parliament of Religions. At the same time, a young monk in India was getting ready to initiate a revolution that would transform America, a revolution for the American soul.
When Vivekananda appeared, He was the superstar of the conference because he was this great erudite, wise person who just was captivating. We remember the World's Parliament of Religions now largely because of Vivekananda and his command of English, his knowledge of Western culture because he was educated in British schools in India, and he was able to present it in a way that was tremendously appealing.
Sisters and brothers of America, I thank you in the name of the most ancient order of monks of the world. I thank you in the name of the mother of all religions. I am proud to belong to a religion which has taught the world both tolerance and universal acceptance. We believe not only in universal toleration, but we accept all religions as true.
Vivekananda's first students were mostly women, the educated elite of Chicago and Boston, who found in him a perfect blend of contemporary spiritual thought mixed with compelling Eastern mysticism.
How does a guy show up in the West and becomes an absolute rock star? You know, dazzles the likes of J.D. Rockefeller, William James, Nikola Tesla, Emma Calvey, the superstar opera singer, Sarah Bernhardt, the greatest actress of her time, to becoming almost forgotten. This is the man who introduced the concepts of yoga and meditation to the West.
In 1895, during a retreat in Thousand Islands Park, Vivekananda formulated his vision and core teachings that would one day become a global movement of universalism and peace.
She stayed for a few years and established the Vedanta Society, the major source of dissemination of Hindu teachings for the first part of the 20th century. And you could see what I mentioned earlier, the lines of succession, the transmission. Houston Smith, he's in the 1950s, and it's scholar of the last 50 years. Joseph Campbell, who's influenced millions and millions of people. Aldous Huxley, Christopher Isherwood, J.D. Salinger, the novelist. All these people, as young men, were schooled by the Vedanta Society Swamis.
The road to salvation is difficult to pass through, as difficult as the sharp edge of a razor. But this much we know, and all religions teach it. There is in every one of us a spark of the infinite goodness which created us. And when we leave this earth, we are reunited with it, as a raindrop falling from heaven is at last reunited with the seed which gave it birth.
The Force?
Now, the Force is what gives the Jedi his power. It's an energy field created by all living things. It surrounds us and penetrates us. It binds the galaxy together.
This is the construct.
This isn't real.
What is real? How do you define real? If you're talking about what you can feel, what you can smell, what you can taste and see, then real is simply electrical signals interpreted by your brain.
He taught Americans that everyone had a spark of divinity. He taught them that all religions were true, because they all led to the same ultimate truth. He showed us that the divine spark within each of us was a reflection of that very consciousness from which the whole universe arose. Everyone who met him was inspired and taken by this charismatic teacher. He changed the way America saw themselves and the way the world saw India forever. In 2017, join us as we discover America's first guru.